Hello everyone, welcome back. So today we are going to learn very important topic, that is potential energy stored in a electric dipole when it is kept in a uniform electrical field. So this is a topic from your unit number 2 of 12 physics, that is electrical potential and capacitance. So if you don't want to learn this topic right now, what you do, you just subscribed, like on click on bell icon, like this video so that it will be saved in a like folder, and in future you can watch it. That will save your time in searching the video. Another important thing is, if you want to learn right now, use your headphones, watch it in one sitting without any disturbance, be with pen and your notebook, and write everything what I write. If you don't understand, rewind the video. This concept I have explained in detail. One big derivation with some special cases and with some numerical I have explained. Numericals are not sufficient, but with this concept, if you understand the concept, you can solve more number of numericals. And write something in comment box. If you have any suggestions, if you have any doubt or anything, you write something in comment box. It's my request, because that will help me to improve this channel. Okay, so there is always a scope for improvement. But for that, I need your suggestions. Please subscribe, place on bell icon, and write in something in comment box. Okay, so let's start. So important topic of class 12 physics, chapter 2, that is electric potential and capacitance, is potential energy of a dipole in an external electrical field or electric field. So today we are going to discuss this topic. First of all, you should know what is electric dipole. Okay, so electric dipole is what? Suppose one charge is there. Suppose this is a positive charge, this is a positive charge, and one is negative charge. Okay, same magnitude, this is Q suppose, and this is also Q, and these are kept at distance. Suppose this distance is, let us say, 2L. Okay, this distance is very, very small distance. Okay, and let us assume some center here in between, and so this distance is L. And okay, so this distance will be L, and this distance is also L. This distance is also L. Okay, so total distance 2L. Now this combination is called electric dipole. This combination is called electric dipole. One is positive charge and one is negative charge. Magnitude is same. Okay, and they are unlike charges. Okay, and this 2L distance is very, very small. Then this combination is called what? Electric dipole. Okay, and due to this, when electric dipole moment will form P. P is equal to what? This P is equal to what? This P is equal to what? Q charge into distance between these two charges, 2L. So this is a P. And this P is a vector quantity. Its direction is from negative to positive. This direction is from negative to positive. Okay, so this is a prerequisite to understand potential energy of a dipole in an electrical field. So this is all about dipole. So such a kind of dipole is kept in an external field. Okay, external field means source is different. Electrical field produced by dipole we are not considering. It is kept in an external field. Okay, some field is there, field lines are like this, and this is one big charge suppose, and these are the field lines like this. Okay, and in this dipole is kept, this dipole is shifted, and it is kept in this field. Okay, so this topic we are going to discuss. So let us start. I will erase this part because this already you have learned. I hope you know the dipole moment, electric dipole, and uniform field. Okay, so let's start.
Let's consider electric dipole is kept in a uniform field as shown. So this is a uniform field, this is the direction, and from left to right, and these are the equispaced lines, parallel and equispaced lines, and straight lines, means this indicates it is a uniform field. This is what uniform field. And why it is external? Because this is produced by some other charge. Charge may be some positive charge, a big charge, positive charge on this side, and this is producing this electrical field. Okay, or maybe some negative charge on this side, and this direction will be towards that charge. So this is a direction of field. So either you consider this or this direction is from left to right, we have considered, and this is a external field. Okay, and in this external field, this dipole is fixed. Now, how is the dipole? Dipole is a combination of two charges. So this is a negative charge. So this is a negative charge here I have shown, and this is a positive charge. Okay, this is a this green dot, and this green dot. This is a negative charge, and this is a positive charge. Okay, so these two charges are kept, and this distance between these two, let us say 2L. Okay. So this is a dipole which is kept at theta 1 angle. This angle is made by electrical field with this dipole moment. This P is a dipole moment. What is the dipole moment? This dipole moment is what? Q into 2L. This is Q into 2L. So this already we know. Okay. So this is kept. This is the initial condition. Okay, so you can note down this part. So this is the position 1. In this, what happens? This positive charge will exert some force, and direction of that force is towards the electrical field. Means direction of electrical field and this force. Direction of this force will be this, and electrical field will be in the same direction. That is why plus sign is there. Okay. And magnitude of this force is Q into E. Magnitude of this force is Q into E. Charge into field. So in the same way, on this side, this force will be there. Direction will be this. That is why negative sign is. This negative sign indicates what? Direction is opposite to the field. So on electron, the force due to this field will be opposite to the field. Okay. But magnitude will be same because charge is same, field is same. Magnitude of charge is same and field is also same. So amount of this force and this force is equal but opposite in direction. So this will happen when this dipole is kept in a uniform field. Now these two forces, the direction in this situation, the angle made by the dipole moment P with the field is theta 1. So this is a theta 1 angle. Okay, this is a theta 1 angle. So this angle is made by this dipole moment P. What is P? P is a dipole moment. Its direction is from negative to positive charge. Okay. And this angle is made theta 1 with the electrical field. So this is the situation. Now, the force, total force acting on the dipole is 0. On this dipole, dipole is a combination of these two charges. So there are two forces are acting. This is one force and this is another force. But these two forces are acting on one body or one dipole, and they are opposite in direction and equal in magnitude. So they will cancel each other. They will cancel each other. That is why total force on the dipole is 0. Total force on the dipole is what? 0. Total force on the dipole is 0. So though the force is 0, force 0 means what? This dipole cannot move, this dipole cannot move in this direction, cannot move in this direction, because these two forces will balance, and due to that this will not move in this direction also. So nowhere linear motion of this dipole, complete assembly of two charges, is not possible. Okay, that is a meaning of this F is equal to 0. F net is 0 means transitional equilibrium will be there. But as these two forces are opposite in direction, but they are not collinear forces. Collinear forces means what? If two forces are acting on one body, one in this direction, one is in this direction, but they are on one line, direction is collinear, then total force is zero, but torque will be zero. Torque will be zero. But if two forces are there like this on this body, one is here and other is here, one is acting in this direction, one is acting in opposite direction, but these are not collinear forces, then they will produce a torque. So body starts rotating. Okay. So same is happening here. These two forces are equal in magnitude, opposite in direction, but they are not collinear. That is why this torque will be produced, and this torque here in this case will be clockwise direction. Okay, so this will act in this direction, this will act in this direction. So due to that, what will happen? So this kind of torque will be developed, clockwise torque will be developed. Sorry, so in this direction, and this is a direction. So in this direction, this will, a tendency of rotation will be like this. Okay, so this will happen. So means what? Torque is not zero in this case. So rotation is possible. So rotational equilibrium is not there in this case, in the position one. Now, so as the tendency is of this clockwise direction, what we will do? We will rotate. We will rotate this dipole. So before that, I will tell you how to calculate this torque. This torque can be calculated by this formula. This can be calculated by this formula. Torque is equal to, it is a cross product of dipole moment and electrical field. So this formula is already derived in a previous topic. Okay. And magnitude can be P into sine theta. Theta is the angle between P and E. So this can be the magnitude of this torque. Now what we will do? This dipole we will rotate. Let's assume this dipole is rotated in the anti-clockwise direction, and now the angle made by the dipole moment with field is theta 2. Means this dipole is rotated from this position to this position. Okay. Now this angle from this line is theta 2. Okay, this is theta 2. And previous angle was theta 1. This was also measured from this line. Okay. So, now, but this tendency of rotation of the dipole was in clockwise direction, and now we are rotating it in anti-clockwise direction. Means, this can be possible by external force only. So, we are applying some external force on this, and we are rotating this in anti-clockwise direction. Now, the position is theta 2, that is the position. Okay, now work done in this process, that work done we have to calculate. Now in this case, angular work done will be there due to this rotation. Linear work done will not be there because F is 0. So W is equal to what? F into displacement. But this force is 0, total force. This total force acting on this 0. Okay. So total force is 0, this force, that is why this work done will be 0. But angular work done will be there. So this work done we have to calculate. Okay. Now, how to calculate this work done? As work done by linear force is F into S, this will be torque into angular displacement. So this will be torque into angular displacement, this formula. So this is a dot product of torque and angular displacement. But this torque is not constant here. Okay. If constant torque is there, you can use this formula. But this theta is continuously changing. So torque is continuously changing. So we cannot use directly this formula. We have to go for integration method. So as this equation is for constant torque, this equation is for constant torque, But here torque is variable, so this equation used for work done for this rotation from theta 1 theta 2 is integration of this small angle and torque. This is the dot product of this. So we have to solve this integration so that we will get work done, and this work done will be stored as a potential energy. This work done will be stored as a potential energy of a dipole. Okay, so you note down this, then we will discuss how to calculate this work done. Now look, as the torque is produced due to the electric force, we can say that the work done above is work done by the electric force. So this torque produced is due to the electrical force. Okay, F force was there, that is Q into E, and due to that, that torque is produced. So we can say the work done will be done by electrical force, indirectly we can say. Okay, so this work is done by torque, but torque is due to electrical force. So work done, we can say it is done by electrical force. So how to calculate? So as I told you, this work done, only I have added this electrical force word. So this is the work done by electrical force will be the dot product of torque into displacement. Torque into displacement. And limit from theta 1 to theta 2. Because displacement is from theta 1 to theta 2. Now we will solve this. So this dot product can be written as tau into d theta into cos theta. But angle is 180 because this torque, tendency of the torque was clockwise, and this rotation we have given is anticlockwise. So direction of rotation was opposite to each other. That is why we have taken angle 180 degree. So cos 180 is minus 1. So this equation will become like this. So as angle here is 180 degree, because of torque and rotation are in opposite direction, so work done will be minus this cos 180 is minus. So negative theta 1 to theta 2 torque into d theta. So we have to solve this equation. So this value of torque we will put P into sin theta. Already we have discussed this in the previous slide. So P into sin theta into d theta. So this integration PE we can take common. So this PE minus and this PE is taken outside. This is constant. And so we have to integrate this sin theta now. So this integration of sin theta is what? Integration of sin theta is what? Cos theta. So minus PE as it is. And integration of sin theta is minus cos theta. Limit is theta 1 to theta 2. This we have to solve. So this can be solved like this. Upper limit and lower limit we can put. This is upper limit is theta 2, lower limit is theta 1. So, and this minus minus becomes plus here. This minus and this minus becomes plus here. So that is why plus P into bracket cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1 we will get. Now this work done is stored as potential energy. How? What is the definition of potential energy? Difference of potential energy, final potential energy minus initial potential energy, is the negative work done by conservative force. Negative work done by conservative force. And this work done, this electrical force is a conservative force. So this work done by this we can say as a work done by electrical force, we can say as a work done by conservative force, and we will apply negative sign. Then this value becomes potential difference in difference in the potential energy, okay, du. So let us equate this. So this change in potential energy is equal to value of this, we will put negative sign as it is from this value, negative sign as it is, only value of this we will put, only value of this is this. So this we are putting here. So we are getting this equation. Now this potential energy, we will modify this equation. Okay, this is the final equation basically, but we have to modify this with some assumptions, because in many cases we have done assumptions. So likewise, only I am changing the notations here. UF is for theta 2 and UI is for theta 1. So like this. Then important assumptions are, let theta 1 is equal to 90 degree. Theta 1 is 90 degree, let us assume, and potential energy at this angle, that is U90, is 0. Okay, so in the previous case we have assumed potential energy at the infinity is 0, and that is why we have calculated the potential energy at a particular point, but basically that is the potential energy difference. Okay, same case is here. This is basically a potential difference, a potential energy difference, but we will assume this potential energy as a 0. Okay, so potential energy at this angle will be 0, and this angle we are saying as a 90 degree. Okay, this is just assumption which is accepted by everybody, so we have to accept it, and we will rearrange the equation. So this theta 2 as it is, this theta 2 as it is, this is at 90 degree, this is as it is, this theta 2 is as it is, and here I will put 90 degree. So this cos 90 is what? 0, and this is also 0. Okay, so this term will be vanished, this term will be vanished. Now we will rewrite the equation like this. So this equation we are getting, this equation. Okay, now in general, this equation is what? Potential energy at a particular point at theta 2 is minus PE into cos theta 2. So make it general. So in general, this can be written as like this. So this U is equal to minus PE into cos theta. U is equal to what? Minus PE into cos theta. So in this way, we can write the potential energy at a particular point. Basically, this is the potential energy difference, but here potential energy of at some place, at initial place, we are assuming 0, and that is why we are saying potential energy at a particular point. But basically, this is the potential difference. Okay, so with this assumption, whatever assumption we have done, with this assumption we can say this is the potential energy at a particular point, that is minus P into cos theta, where theta is the angle between dipole and field. Okay, always remember, this is very important, theta is the angle between dipole and field, because in the numerical this angle may be given in different way, so we have to calculate this angle, we have to convert that angle in this as per this, and then we have to use in the equation. Now, if you observe this equation, U is equal to minus P into cos theta, this P is a vector quantity, dipole moment, this electrical field also vector quantity, into cos theta, means definitely this is a dot product of something, P and E. So finally, this equation can be written like this, U is equal to minus sign as it is, and this is a, to eliminate this cos theta, I will write like this. So it is a dot product of two vectors, dipole moment and electrical field. So this is the final equation of potential energy, and in magnitude form we can write like this. Okay, so this is a potential energy of dipole which is kept in a external electric field. So this is a equation. Okay, so in magnitude form, this is the equation. So remember this equation, minus P into cos theta. So I hope you understood everything. Now in this, we will discuss some important cases. So let's start that also. You note down this. If you have not understood, you just rewind the video and write everything. Try to learn. Now let's go to next part. We will learn some special cases. Configuration 1, theta is equal to 90 degree, means theta is what? Angle made by the dipole moment with the electrical field, and this angle is 90 degree, means if the field is horizontal, dipole will be vertical. If field is vertical, then dipole moment will be horizontal. So like this. So this field is here horizontal, and this dipole is, this will be the direction of dipole moment P, okay, from negative. This is a negative charge and this is a positive charge. So direction will be from negative to positive. So this angle is 90 degree here. Okay. So this is the configuration 1 or position 1. Situation 1 we can say. So here let us write all the equations. F net is 0 always. Total force acting on the dipole is 0 always. Okay. Then torque, we can calculate value of torque. Torque will be P into sine theta. Theta here is 90 degree. Sine 90 is 1. So you will get PE. What you will get? Torque is PE, which is the maximum torque you will get in this case. If angle between dipole moment and electrical field is 90 degree, so you will get torque acting on that dipole is maximum, and that value will be P into E. Now what about potential energy? So this potential energy, this is our general formula, minus P into cos theta. Cos theta is 90 degree, and cos 90 degree is 0. So potential energy you are getting is 0 here in this case. This is not minimum, this is not maximum, this is simply 0. Okay, now let us go to another configuration, another position, that is theta is equal to 0. So how the dipole moment or dipole is situated? It is like this. So this is the electrical field, this is the direction of electrical field, and this is the direction of P. So both these directions are same when means theta is equal to 0. So in this case, so F net is also 0 in this case also. Okay, in all cases for the dipole, F net is 0, but torque will be 0 because P, torque is P into sine theta. Theta is 0, sine 0 is 0. So you are getting 0, that is minimum value of torque. Here you are getting maximum value of torque, and here you are getting minimum value, that is 0. And now what about potential energy? Same formula, P into cos theta, but theta is cos 0 is 1, so that is why we are getting minus P. Okay, so this is the minimum potential energy you are getting in this case. Okay, and minimum potential energy means what? Now look, F is 0, so transitional equilibrium is there. Torque is 0 means rotational equilibrium is there. Torque is 0 means body, this dipole will not rotate. So rotation is stopped, linear motions are stopped, means the dipole is in equilibrium position. And equilibrium position means this is a equilibrium means what? This F is 0 and torque is 0. But what kind of equilibrium it is? There are two types of equilibrium. Three types are there basically. But here we will talk about two type of equilibrium, that is stable and unstable equilibrium. For stable equilibrium, potential energy is minimum. And here also we are getting potential energy minimum, means this is a stable equilibrium. Okay, so this is what a stable equilibrium we are getting in this case. So when theta is equal to 0 means direction of dipole moment and field is same, then we can say body or dipole will be at stable equilibrium. Now configuration 3, theta is equal to 180 degree means what? This is the direction of electrical field to the right side, and this is P, from negative charge to positive charge, means it is opposite to the field, means angle will be 180 degree. Now let us write equations. F net is 0 and sine 180 is also 0, so P sine 180 is 0. So here also we are getting torque minimum, that is 0, means body is at equilibrium. F is 0, tau is 0, torque is 0, means rotational motions and linear motions are stopped. Restricted means this dipole is at equilibrium, but what kind of equilibrium? Here we will calculate potential energy minus P into cos theta. Cos theta is theta is 180, cos 180 is minus 1. So minus 1 into this minus, it will become plus. So finally you are getting plus potential energy, which is a maximum potential energy you are getting. And when maximum potential energy is there and F is 0, tau is 0, means this is a unstable equilibrium is there. So what is difference between two basically? Our understanding of this is what? F is 0, tau is 0, but only the difference in potential energy. In stable equilibrium, minimum potential energy. Unstable equilibrium is maximum potential energy. And body always tries to achieve stable equilibrium. Means what? Suppose in stable equilibrium, if this dipole is given some deflection, if dipole is given some deflection, very small, so it will oscillate like this. It will go here and it will oscillate like this. Okay, so it will oscillate in between this. Okay, so it will oscillate like this. And finally it will come to the initial position, that is horizontal position. And again, same condition will be achieved and stable equilibrium will be achieved. Okay, this is a stable equilibrium. But what happens in unstable equilibrium? If little deflection, if you give some force, if you apply on this side, it will go here and this positive charge will go here and negative charge will come here and this position will be achieved. So body will move towards the stable equilibrium if the small deflection is given to the dipole when the dipole is at unstable equilibrium. So this is the difference. Okay. So in this way we have learned the potential energy stored in a dipole when it is kept in a uniform electrical field, and these three cases, important three cases, we have learned. Now let us solve some numericals based on this topic and then we will stop. So let us take numerical 1. So situation is, look, dipole is there and field is there, both directions are same. Now what is the question? Situation given is what? Dipole, rotate dipole from 0 to 180 degree, means initial condition was 0, this was the condition. Now dipole is rotated by 180 degree, means this will go in this direction and this will go in this direction. So it is rotated like this, or rotated from stable to unstable equilibrium. Means at 0 degree stable equilibrium is there and at 180 degree unstable equilibrium is there. So they may ask you, wording they may change. They may ask you rotate from 0 to 180 degree or rotate from stable equilibrium to unstable equilibrium. Okay, and this was the initial, this was a given case, is the initial condition. What is the work done by the external force in this type of rotation? This is a question. So how to calculate? So work done means what? Potential energy. And we know the formula for potential energy. So let us use that. Options are also given. So this is a formula. Change in potential energy is work done. So write formula for final potential energy, minus P into cos theta. This is the formula, minus P into cos theta. Value of theta is for final position, value is 180. So 180 I have put here. And then minus sign into bracket. Again, formula for potential energy is minus P into cos theta. So theta here for initial condition is 0 degree. So minus P into cos 0. Now cos 180 is minus 1. Cos minus 1 and cos 0 is plus 1. So this minus minus will become plus. And this minus minus will become plus. So let us write. So this will become P and this will become P. Positive, positive. So finally you will get 2P. Okay, finally you will get 2P. So 2P means what? Option D. So option D is the answer. Got it? What we have calculated? Potential energy difference formula we have written, and general formula P into cos theta we have used, and we have put the values of final and initial condition and we have got the answer. So this is a simple example. Let us solve another simple example. So this is a sketch. Position 1, position 2 are given. Find the work done in rotating dipole from position 1 to position 2 by electrical force. Now look, position 1 was this, means angle is 60 degree. Angle between P and E is 60 degree. And in position 2, this is angle. In position 2, this is angle. 60 degree is there. But this angle is made by this dipole with the electrical field, but in the opposite direction. And in the derivation, which angle we have taken? This angle we have taken, this theta 2, and this was theta 1. This was theta 1. So this 60 is theta 1. So theta 1 is equal to 60 degree, no problem. But this theta 2 we have to calculate. Now, if this is a horizontal line, look, this is 180, total is 180 degree. This is 60, 60, means this angle will be 60 degree. This angle will be 60 degree. And this is your theta 2. Means theta 2 will be what? 60 plus 60. This 60 and this 60. 60 plus 60 is 120. Okay. So here, these are the values. So let us write the equation. Options are also given. So here theta 1 is equal to 60 degree and theta 2 is equal to 120 degree. This 120 degree, this 60 degree. Okay, understood. So in this way, in the previous case, direct angles they have given, but in this case directly they have not given. We have to calculate. That is why we must remember that derivation. Then let us write the equation in the same way. Let us put the values 120 and 60 degree. And let us write the values. So cos 120 is minus 120 and cos 60 is plus 120. Remaining part as it is. Okay, this same procedure we have repeated here. And only change in the values. So this will become 1 upon 2 PE and this will become 1 upon 2 PE. So total will be PE. So option will be PE means what? Where is option? PE means option C. So option C is the answer. So I hope you have understood everything. Note down this. I am erasing this part. So you note down. I hope you have understood everything. If you have not understood, repeat the video, rewind the video, watch it again, write everything. Okay. And if you have any doubt, any suggestion, you write in comment box. This is very important. You are not using comment box. Please write something in comment box. Like it, share it, subscribe it. Okay, if you are not subscribed. So, thank you.